Hi, this is Andy from Adobe. Today I'll show you a handy way to animate the contents of a web page so that it stays synchronized with an embedded video. First, let's see what it looks like. So I have a sample project here, which I will preview. And it's a simple page with an embedded video. This video is from my colleague Michael Shez. And as you can see, once the video plays, I've dropped in some animations. And the point is to have the animations not compete with the video, but sort of complement what's going on in the foreground. And you can pause, you can jump back and forth, you can scrub, and the video keeps in time with the animations. And at the end, when I want people to focus on the video, you can blank out the page in the background, and it's a cool effect. So let's take a look at how it's done. Now I'm building my animations in Edge Animate because I think it's the best tool for DOM animations. And I'll just make my document 100% and give myself some room to work here. And there are basically three things that we need to do. First, I need an animation for the web page. Second, I need to embed my video into that animation. And then third, I need some script to synchronize them and so they keep time. Now, first I'll lay out my animation, and this is going to be pretty simple. I will make a holder for my video, and we'll use the same video. Let me check the size. It's I'll do 560 by 315, but it can be anything. So 560, 315. Oops, it's linked. I'll unlink that. 560. Okay, that'll be where the video will go a little bit later. Now I want just a placeholder animation for the sake of time, so I'm just going to make a ball and animate it across the screen. And in this case, I'm going to make an animation on the root timeline of the same length as the video and just keep them directly in time. We could do more complicated things, but that'll do for now. And so the video is 1 minute 20. I'll zoom out my timeline here so I can see that far. There we go. And now I'll make a pinned animation. Turn on pinning. I'll drag out the yellow half of the pin to 1 minute 20. There we go. And now I just drag my things to where I want them to wind up. So I'll animate this ball over to the side of the screen, and I don't know, we'll turn it blue. Why not? Okay. Okay, so there's our animation. And we'll just preview that. And yeah, it looks great. Clients will pay big money for that. Good, ship it. Okay, now step two is to embed the YouTube video into my animation. Now, first thing I need to do is I'm going to select this symbol here and give it a symbol name, video underbar holder. And that will let me access this element from the Edge Animate API. Now, to actually do the embed, I'm going to start writing some script. The final version of the script is over on my blog, but for now we'll work through it from the simple way first. So I want this to happen on startup, so I will select the stage, go to my actions button, and I'm going to make a creation complete event handler, and that'll fire as soon as the whole animation is ready to start. Now the Edge Animate API is based on jQuery, so if you're not familiar with jQuery, bear with me for a moment because I'm going to use some jQuery magic. Every Edge Animate event handler gets this sim property, and it exposes jQuery to me. So I'm going to call jQuery magic and get a direct reference to the video holder symbol object, a symbol element. And on that element, I can call the HTML method, which will just replace the content of that element with some arbitrary HTML. And for what HTML to use, for now, I will just go back to YouTube and use their embed code directly. But there's something you need to know here. YouTube has two different kinds of embed code. There's the old version, which uses embed and embeds a flash player. And then there's the new version, if you uncheck that, which embeds an iframe. And then the contents of that iframe might be flash, might be HTML, depending on the situation. Now, if you want your project to play back on mobile devices, obviously you need to use the new version of the code so YouTube can serve up an HTML video if it needs to. But the code that we're going to do later to sync up the animations is a lot more complicated if you use an iframe. So for now, I'm going to use the the old version because it's simpler. So I'll just copy that script as is, come back here and put it right into the HTML method. And I think I might put that in a string. Yeah. And let's give it a shot. There we go. So the video is embedded in the page, the animation is playing, and now I just need to sync them up. Now the code for this is a little bit longer, so I'm going to copy and paste it and not make you watch me type, but it's still pretty simple. Now first I'm going to overwrite this with some different code, and let's take a look. Now there's a whole API for you accessing YouTube videos from JavaScript, and it's well documented, you can check it out. But the simple things we're going to do here are, first, when you embed a YouTube player, it automatically calls this onYouTubePlayerReady function as soon as it's ready. So I'm going to catch that and make a reference, keep a reference to the player called player, and I'll add an event listener for onStateChange. And that's going to be called anytime the video plays or pauses. And I'll define a handler to call, and it's right here. And then in this handler, all I'll do is I'll get current time from the player object. I will multiply it by 1,000 to convert from milliseconds to seconds, and then I'll just pass it to the play or stop methods of symbol. And this script is attached to the stage, so the symbol in this case is the stage. So this will just play or pause the root timeline from whatever the current time is of the YouTube video, and this will happen every time the video plays or pauses. Easy peasy. And down here I've changed the code just a little bit from before. First, I've pulled out the video code so it's easier to change, and then there's a couple of parameters that I add on to the embed statement. And these are basically, they tell YouTube to enable the JavaScript API. And this all comes directly off the YouTube JavaScript API documentation pages, so it's really easy to set up. Now let's preview this and see if it works. Okay. And the videos are keeping time. Perfect. Awesome. The only thing is you saw that the video autoplayed before the YouTube video had started, so I'll jump back here, select the stage, and I will turn off autoplay. And that's it. The basics are now done. But before we finish, I want to go back to what I said before about embedding things in an iframe, and I'll show you the code in my finished project here. Now this code is meant to be modified, so I've pulled out the video name, the width and the height, and so on, so they can be easily changed. But I've also got a boolean here, whether or not to use an iframe. And things work a little bit differently when you're embedding versus when you're using the iframe. Now, when you're embedding, like I said before, you just make the object tag, you pass it right into the HTML of this video holder, and then this function will get called as soon as the YouTube video is ready. When you're using an iframe, it's a little bit different. First, you have to define a script tag, make an actual tag for a script element, set its source to be the iframe API that's provided by Google, then that script is what's going to set up all your events. And the events are accessed a little bit differently, different function here, but also you're getting a real event with real objects rather than just a code directly. So I catch the event, I call its data property, and that's the same one and two that we got before in the older embed API, and I pass it up to the same event handler like before. And then as before, you make an iframe tag, and you plop it right there into the HTML property of the thing we made earlier. And the other difference that you have to be aware of is that when you're doing this with an iframe, the YouTube API has to explicitly give permission to your content to call JavaScript functions inside the iframe. And to do that, it has to know what site your content is at. So I've pulled that out into a variable called site URL, which is up at the top in the settings, and that would just be the name of your site. And by the way, when you're testing this previewing directly from Edge Animate has a minimal web server built into it that it uses to preview content. So when you preview stuff, it looks like it's being served from localhost 54321. So if we pass that to the YouTube API, then everything works. So let's make sure that it works in iframe mode. Mm-hmm. This is now using the iframe, and just like before, we're still getting the animations all synced up. So there you have it, visually authored animations playing in HTML5 and synchronized to an embedded video. Pretty cool stuff. Try it, let me know how it works out. And this is Andy from Adobe, and I'll see you next time.